Oh, hello, everybody. Hello, hello, my dear friend. Hello. I remind you that my name is Anna Dixon, and today we will speak about secrets of good retention. I'm very happy to see all of you today. Hi, hi. Can you write me hi if you hear me and see me well? I think we will wait about 5, 10 minutes, everybody else. Hello, Katrina. Hello, Gemma. Joanna. Hi. I don't know if you are my student or it's the first time we meet. Anyway, it's very, very nice to meet with you. Where are you from? I It's, oh, 17 people. Oh, it's very nice. This is my second time. Hi, Marie. Oh, hi, hello. Oh, hi, hi. Hi, Gemma. Nice to meet you. My name is Anna. I'm very happy that first time you are with me. We are waiting people like about 10 minutes, and we are ready to start. And if you have any question, you can ask me right now, and we can start to talk, just meet, and we have a little bit time for just if you have any question, you can ask me right now. What is your biggest problem with the retention and permanent makeup? How long you are doing it? Oh, hello, England. What time in England now? What time is it? Maybe. Oh, it's evening. Nice. It's 10 a.m. in Los Angeles. Gemma, it depends. Usually it takes 1 hour, but it's my second webinar only. Last time it was 1 hour. The most intensive it's about 20, 30 minutes, and then it's just chit chat and hi Patricia. Hi. If you have a lot of questions, I'm open to answer all of them. So it does not matter if it will take 1 or 2 hours. Yes, and me too. I love teaching. So please welcome. Feel free to ask any questions. Okay, we are waiting 5 more minutes. Check if you see the slide of presentation. Can you see it on the screen? Like, welcome. Joanne, oh, thank you so much. I'm very proud of my online classes, and it's very nice that we have internet. It's God bless internet because I can work online and share by all my knowledges with you. Oh, no, Gemma, you don't need something. It's not like teaching. It's more like consultation. But if you will take dots class, you will need the material because I'm doing online course about 2 years. In March will be 2 years, and in this year we start new program. I create new format. Yes. Yes, every webinar will be recorded and it's possible to watch after. And in this year, I decided to change format and start to do online courses with homework for you have a chance to improve your skills. The idea that you're working with a fake skin and make a recording and send it to me back so I can check if you are doing something wrong with my recommendation. Okay, we are waiting last 2 minutes and we are ready to start. Let me know if you hear me well and see me well. So I don't need to be worried about. Connection is good, I hope. No, it's so nice. All good here in UK. I hope everything is good, not just my webinar. So interesting, like many people over the world, we are together. It's so nice. I'm still new in webinars and doing online, so do you also teach nano shading, Gemma? What is nano shading? I don't know. There are so many names of the same techniques. Nano, HD, 3D, a lot of very smart and modern words. What does it mean, nano shading? I'm doing nice shading. Nice looking shading. Yes, this is my favorite technique. Nano needles and classic needles, not big different. Maybe for hair strokes, it's a little bit, but even for this technique, it's not big. Yeah, it's all these names. It's just about money. It's sad sometimes. Yeah, I'm doing permanent up to 10 years, and in fact, I can say that I'm using maybe okay. Dense color, ombre, soft powder. It's a single technique with single needle. This is second one. Hair strokes and manual shading and microblading. That's it. It's not so much the same. Yes, I think I get it. If I don't answer in online course, it's because I'm maybe busy and I can lose the message sometimes. If I didn't answer like one day, you can write me again. It's not because I don't want to answer or something, it's just I can lose it because it's too much. There are lots of messages. And I'm always answer to my student, and it's better if you didn't answer, if you didn't get my answer, you can write me personally by WhatsApp and repeat your question. And I'm so sorry if I did not answer for your question. Usually I'm doing it without any problem. If somebody write me personally, I answer immediately. Okay. Please welcome everybody. We are not waiting. If somebody late, it's not our problem. We can't wait too long. Okay, let's start our webinar about secrets of good retention. My name is Anna Dixon, and yes, I am a doctor. Today I will try to explain you what you need to know for have a good result with eyebrows because it has to be. Always there is a reason for bad result in permanent makeup, and let's speak about these difficulties today. So please welcome, and you can ask me a question during my presentation, but try to wait a little bit, let me finish. But if it's something important to ask right now, you can write. Yes, we will speak about microblading today a lot because I think microblading is very popular now and lots of people to do. And with microblading, we have big problem with retention. It's true. I think it's the most difficult technique, and success, it depends on many, many, many factors, and we will speak about it today. So microblading is in the focus today. Okay. What is really important? It's when you start to work, you need to think about skin type, equipment and needles, technique, pigments, and aftercare. There are some other things, but these five is the most important to get a good result. Okay, what I mean when I tell skin type? Skin type is the most important because I'm not cosmetologist, and maybe there is other names of type of the skin. But I'm trying to easy explain you what is different. For me, it's much easier to think about just two groups of skin types. First, it's transparent and not transparent. Let me explain you what's different, transparent and not transparent. Transparent skin, it's skin with less amount of collagen into it, like my skin. It's, you can call it dry skin, but when you look at the skin, you can see that this skin is more transparent than oily skin, for example. But not all not transparent skin are oily. So when you look at the girls, the main indicator, it's our brows. So when you look at the brows and see that hair is tiny and soft, it means that skin is not transparent, not so strong, not so thick. And when skin is not transparent, usually girls have very, very thick and strong hair. So this is a main indicator. Let me show you examples. You see the screen well? If yes, just write me yes or something. Just put plus so I can be sure that you see what I'm trying to show you on the screen. Yeah, very good. Okay, for example, see her own brow is thick enough. This is a healed result, and her hair is thick enough, and you see that her skin is a little bit oily. It's a little bit not transparent. And this girl, for example, look, her hair, her brows is very thick, and skin not transparent. And let me find that picture of girls with transparent skin. Not, what? I put a lot of I put a lot of picture with Let me find the picture with transparent skin. Like mine, if you look at my brows, my skin is very thin and soft. And it's not so. You have I don't know what it's in different areas, different in different countries, it's different skin types. But in I see that here in LA it's more can you see this picture now? Yeah, I think yes. This is a new picture. You see, this girl compare previous girls. Her hair is like mine, and her skin is transparent. Her hair is very soft, and you can see the retention. So this is immediately after. This is retention. It's a healed result after first just one first session, and you see how much color it's. After first procedure, and this is very effectively. It's not because of technique, it's because of her skin type. So when we see it's like when you look at the girls, look at her hair on eyebrows, look at her wrinkles, the transparent skin has a lot of tiny wrinkles. And not transparent skin like this. They have no a lot of little one, but they usually have big, deep, but not a lot. So it can be shining here, but not all this. Hi, Kiara. Hi, Kiara. I'm very happy that you are with me today. So if you see difference and decide what is her skin type, then you can choose technique. With not transparent skin, like thick skin, we need to work with a dense color and dense technique. And with transparent skin like this, we can work with transparent technique, like soft powder, stardust, it's the same. Okay, what is transparent and not transparent techniques? Transparent techniques, it's techniques with a pixels effect, like single needle. It's soft powder effect, stardust, nano shading. What else? HD shading. Just some like magic shade or something like this. If you see on the picture that it looks like this, like very soft powdering, it means that it's made by a single needle. But it's the biggest problem that this technique does not work with not transparent skin. So it does not work with thick skin like oily skin. Let me explain you why. Because single needle is very damaging needle. It does not work effectively with a skin with how to say so when skin has a lot of collagen, process of regeneration is very active. And with this skin type, it does not work because one single needle is damaged skin a lot. And it can't heal properly. And it's not possible to cover up not something not transparent but transparent technique. Let me explain what I mean. For example, this girl, her skin is not transparent. You see that her hair is very thick and strong. and she's shiny little bit here, like this area on the forehead, nose, and you see that her skin is very, very thick. And this is a after maybe a couple weeks picture, and just for this skin type, it's very, very visible that process of regeneration is very active. And this is healed result after first session. So it's immediately after. This is couple weeks, and you see that skin is regenerated very active and produce a lot of collagen. And this is healed result. So color is a rise because I put a lot of into the skin. And if you will look on the girls with not such a difficult skin type, this is a first, third, 5, 8, 9 days. You see that regeneration, and this is 9 day after, so you know that color will arise also, but in the 9th day it looks already good. So there is no such a terrible scabs or skin regeneration process. Why? Because of her skin. But this is oily also. With dark girls and with any type of not transparent skin. So let me show you. This is this girl. And this girl. It's the same skin type for us, for permanent makeup. It's thick by the same way. So this girl, she's white. She has no a lot of melanin, but she still has not transparent skin. At what I want to tell you. We will speak about aftercare today. Yeah, we will speak about it. So the doesn't matter black or white. It's important that this skin is not transparent. So look at the hair, it's the same. So don't be focused on the color, be focused on the structure of the skin, how strong it is. Okay, now I think it's maybe more clear for you, I hope. So this girl is also oily, but she's a little bit better. And skin regeneration, it's not so difficult what I want to this I want to show you. And let me show you my favorite picture. It was my model on the I'm talking about this girl. I put it on the front of my presentation. Look at this eyebrows. Let me show you closely. This girl was my model, and she was the first with who I start. It was like 6 years ago, maybe. She was my first with who I did my first dance technique. So when I started to work with group needle, I don't know how it's in your country, but in Russia, single needle technique is very, very popular. So everybody learn how to work with single needle. But with my 10 years of experience, I realized that group needle is more effective for get dense color because after healing we can't see pixels. See, this is a healed result after first session. Her skin is oily, and it was my first time when I get such a nice result. And after this, 6 years ago, I started to work with group needle a lot. And I realized that single needle not so effective, like everybody crazy about it. And look at this. So what I'm trying to tell you, when you have pixels immediately after healing, it's not so visible. So I recommend you don't be so crazy trying to get soft powder and results like pixels, because after healing it's not visible. So and it takes long time during the procedure. And if you so for this brows, I need like 15 minutes and it's done. And if skin is not good for this technique, it can take 1 2 hours for doing it. So, and it's possible to get soft, smooth gradient by group needle also. So this is my recommendation for work with not transparent skin like this. It's work with the group needles. Let's come back to our presentation. And this is the second point, and think it's equipment and needles. Equipment not so important. Very important is choose right needles. So if you are working with not transparent skin, choose group needle. It can be 3 round liner, 5 round liner, or maybe 7. But what is important to understand, when we are working with a lot of needles at the same time, it's much easier to work more surface, because lots of needles can't push on the skin. Oh, my English. I'm so sorry for my English. It's like one needle going into the skin very easy, because nothing can stop. It's like knife in a butter. Three needles goes not so easy, but it's much easier to than big group needle. So if you choose 5 needle at the same time, push it on the skin, and just three needles will go easier than five. So 3 round or 3 round liner. You mean 3 round shader or 3 round liner? I will explain you. Okay, just give me a minute. I will finish and I'll explain the difference between shaders and liners. So number five and number three. Number five goes into the skin more difficult, but because it's impossible to puncture the skin so easy. And it means that biggest group needle work more surface. But what is the point? And it's very important to understand that if it's a lot of needles at the same time, retention will be less. Not so much color. Okay. Yes. Trust me, I'm recording everything. Yeah, let me check. Yes, I'm recording, because I can't speak too much all the time. Yeah. Okay. Have a nice day, and see you. I hope see you in the online course and webinars anywhere, or just write me personally. Okay, let's continue. So when it's big group, retention is less. So we have the biggest retention with single needle, then three needle, then five, then seven, and bigger. So why I recommend to use 3 round liners or 5 round liners? Because you can control the retention. After 7 or 9, you will get just little retention, not too much. So 3 round liner is the most effective needle, but sometimes it's difficult to catch right depth. So with very sensitive skin, you can use bigger size, like 5 or 7. What about shaders and liners? I'm not a big fan of shader configuration because, with my experience, I understand that liners group needle is less traumatic than shaders because, for example, let's talk about five. Five liner and five shader. It's like this. When you are doing movements like pendulum, this is needle is open and it damaged the skin because it's like this. And liner is more accurate. I can say it's like this. It's like bullet a little bit. So on the surface of the skin, it's not so damaging when you are going left and right on the side movements. So if you are doing like this, shader and liner will be the same. But when you are trying to work like pendulum a little bit, and all our movements, it's about side movements. Shader configuration, it will be more damaging. But with some type of skin, it's not like visible. But when you're working with very sensitive skin, like very, very thin, you can see the difference. So you take the same size of needle, one shader and one liner, and with shader, it's bleeding a lot. So I'm trying to work with liners configuration because I'm worried about skin of my clients. It's important when you're working long time because they come back to you after 2, 3, 5 years, and you need to do something with them. And all permanent makeup create micro scars. And when you're working with not damaged techniques, it's much easier to work after 2, 3 years and regular touch-ups with them. So I think with very high that microblading is very popular now, we will have a lots of trouble after 5 years. But let's see. And now we are talking about technique. So when you choose technique, you need to understand what technique is more traumatic and what is not. I know that I will have a lot of, and I already have a lot of troubles because I'm talking like this. But microblading is the most traumatic technique in permanent makeup. The less traumatic technique, the most traumatic is microblading, then is micro shading, so it's shading with manual needles. Then is the hair strokes by machine. Then it's single needles, soft powdering, and the most gentle and sensitive is the group needle working with machine. So one more time, microblading, then micro shading, then hair strokes by machine, then single needle, and then group needle by machine. So, what is when we need? So we are today we are talking about retention. So if we need lots of color, we need to implant a lot of pigment into the skin, and when we need to. It means that we need to work a lot. And if you choose traumatic technique when you need a lot of color into the skin, it means that you will damage the skin a lot. And it will not work because if it's very traumatic, after healing, it's nothing because damage the skin a lot, it's open a lot, it's swelling a lot, and the regeneration is very active. And it's like open wood, and skin need to feel it. And pigmented, it's going out with a scalp. So when we need a lot of color, we need to choose gentle technique for doing by 1, 2, 3 passes maximum, and it's done, and we have a lot of color. So the most important, the most effective technique with my experience, it's group needle by machine, and my new technique, which I create with my 10 years of experience for beginners, it's a dots technique. It's combined with the manual shading or group needle by machine. So for me, it's the most effective techniques for doing dense color on the eyebrows. And we will speak about it. We can start to talk about techniques right now and then continue about pigments and aftercare. Just be sure that I did not forget to tell about it, because I can, because I can forget about it. So pigments and aftercare, it's very important also to get a good result. Okay, let's speak about technique. Oh, it's our favorite one. Everybody crazy about technique, and nobody wants to listen to me when I'm trying to tell very important information about skin types and style and personality and color types and contrast of people. Nobody, it's like just like, I hope that they will like my information. Tell me something good. I want to know if I'm like speaking with myself. Yeah, give me some compliment. Oh, thank you, Faye. Thank you for Patricia. Thank you. Oh yeah. Yeah, now I see that I'm not alone. Okay, this, I think the, for me, it's, oh, thank you so much. I'm just a little bit worried about my English all the time, and I'm talking too much, and I can't see you guys. I wish to see your faces and be. Thank you, Gemma. Thank you for your compliments. Let me ask you, for me it's very important if you understand difference between transparent and not transparent. It's like with your practice with your clients. Now, is it clear for you? Because for choose everything, we need to understand this thing first. So first, it's understand what skin type. Oh, thank you so much, Chiara. Yes, I know, Chiara, you was in my 2 classes, I think, maybe 3. I remember your question. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Katrina. I'm very happy that you understand it. It's nice. Yeah, okay. So when we understand the skin type, let's speak about technique. Okay, now I trust you that you listen to me and understand me. this is a short presentation of dot technique. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, girls. You are the best. I'm like this. If you're doing me compliments and tell me some warm words, I can do everything for you. Just tell me that you enjoy my courses and love me. I will do everything. Then you can ask me about everything. I'm ready. Just a little bit positive. And I love atmosphere on my online course. This is my biggest reason to be proud of myself, because Oh, it touched my heart. It's so cute. I love you girls too.
My hand up and
Okay.
down and left. My hands up and
This
down
is a
and left and
video
right at
from
the
Dot
same time.
Technique.
It looks like my hand is
And
shaking. It's
what
because
the
I'm working
idea
very
is
fast.
to make
You
a,
don't need
it's
to
like
do it so
combine
fast. You
two
can
techniques
work much
together. It's like
slower
skin is not
and
easy. Okay. When I
work
put
much
stuff, it's
slower
picture is
and
not here.
all
Okay.
you need is just don't
What the
put
idea?
dots
So
very
it's
close to each
we need
other.
to get dense color in the middle
For
of
continuing my
eyebrow, and
work,
for this
I
we
change
choose
method for
dense technique,
manual for
like
make dense
group.
color in the middle of eyebrow
Sorry,
and
group
bottom
needle
line.
with
It's very
machine
simple to get
or
dense
with
color
manual
quick
technique,
on
and we
any type
will
of skin.
learn in a dot course this technique together.
And I want to start by where and
And
all you
with the
need is
dot
just
technique,
don't
this is
put
on the
dots very
screen, you
close
can
to each
see
other.
dot technique.
For continue my
And this is a
work,
manual
I
technique.
change method for
And
manual
the idea
for
to
make
combine
dense color in
effect
the
of
middle
soft
of
powder
eyebrow
working
and
by
bottom
dot
line.
technique
It very
and
simple
dense
to get
color,
dense
dense
color
technique in the
quick
middle of
on
eyebrow
any
and the
type of
tail.
skin.
And
And I want to start by the base
okay.
knowledge. So freehand, all you need
So
is just don't put
in the course
dots very
we
close to
will
each other.
learn both of them,
For
two
continue my
techniques
work, I
for
work. I
you. Sorry. Yes, I understand that it's two voices. Okay. Let me finish on the picture and then we can watch video a little bit. So this is the result immediately after. It's dot technique after first session. And you see on this the idea it's to combine two techniques for have an illusion of soft powdering technique, but in fact it's dense technique because the dot technique is also dense and have a good retention. Yeah, Katrina, yeah, it's very good. It's like I create this technique only in this year after 10 years of experience. I just realized how to work with difficult skin type and have retention, good retention. And at the same time, it's nice looking. So this is little secret which will help you to work with any type of skin, even if you have not very good skills and equipment, for example. So this is an imitation of soft powdering on the top of eyebrows and the beginning of eyebrows to make a smooth gradient here and up on the upper line. But you see, this is the healed result. And color is very, very dense as possible to get by permanent makeup. This is a dot technique. And this is a soft powder technique. But in the middle is also manual method, which I recommend to use with dot technique. So you see that after healing this one, and this one, so result is the same. But previous brows takes me more than 2 hours for work. Because working with single needle and catch right depth, it's very difficult. With dots technique, it's much easier because it's very easy to catch the depth and not damage skin a lot. Because when you're working with pendulum, it's scratching the skin, and when you are working with dots, it's very, very gentle. So all you need is just understand how to work with the dots technique, and we will speak about it in an online course a lot. How to not go too deep, and I will show you some tricks, and I will show you exercise for improve your skills, and I will give you homework, and I can see the result from you. This is the most effective way to learn this very simple technique. Let's come back to video. I will for a while. Антон, я потеряла видео. Я его не вижу. In Russian, I'm speaking with my assistant. He will help me to find the video because I lost it. And in the video, you will see. Оно вот оно открыто в Dots Trial YouTube. В следующей вкладке. Вот оно вот. So what I wanted to say. So about dot scores. I will show you the video procedure from start to end with my explanation. And I will give you homework, and also we will speak about pigments, and also we will speak about needles, different type. Also we will speak about equipment and the aftercare and shaping of the eyebrows, because doesn't matter how good your technique, if you so shape is everything. Let's watch the how it's look like.
I start to work from tail, and all I do is just move my hands up and down and left and right at the same time. It looks like my hand is shaking. It's because I'm working very fast. You don't need to do it so fast. You can work much slower, and all you need is just don't put dots very close to each other. For continue my work, I change method for manual for make dense color in the middle of eyebrow and bottom line. It very simple to get dense color quick on any type of skin. And I want to start, but the base.
It was just a short video to explain how it look like, but this procedure takes a long time from start to the end. And as you see in the video, technique is not very clear. It's like you see how I'm doing it, but my goal to explain you how it work. So explain all process. When you understand, you can control it better. That's why I give you homework and show on the fake skin some exercises. And it looks like this. In the video, factoring. Thank you. Yes, beautiful. I'm talking a little bit about pre-round liner, but it's more about manual shading because group needle also not always works. It's not like 100% 100% successfully all the time, but manual shading it always works. All the time. Excuse me. Антон, у меня не включается. Думаешь, с интернетом проблема? Не могу последний куток включить. Ага. Do you slow the machine down? Yes. Before, when I was working with single needle a lot, I always use high speed for working. With a group needle, you can work slowly. And this is a one more reason for why group needle working is more gentle for the skin and less traumatic. So why we need high speed for working with a single needle? Because we are working by pendulum effect. It's like up and down. And I already told that single needle is very traumatic because it's going into the skin very easy, and it's like this slow speed is much more difficult to control the depth. So master need to work very fast, like quick brush, like up and down, like up and down. Because when it's fast, needles can't go into the skin too many times. And with the group needle, it's not so easy for needle go into the skin. That's why we can work slowly, because we can control the depth. It's much easier. Of course, when we use the high speed, it's more traumatic for the skin. So this is one more reason. It's much easier to work with the slow speed. So the slowest, it's a manual method, because with it's super slow and super effective, because every tap by manual shading gives you color, so you can tap, wipe it, and you see the result. With single needle, you are doing one pass, two passes, three passes, wipe it, and sometimes it's nothing. Speed is for single needle, and group, you need slower speed for group working with a group needle. Yes, manual sounds like soft tap, because I'm using soft tap is one of methods for manual shading. I love it because needle is angled, so soft top needle lay on the skin with 45 degree, and it's more comfortable for you. So it's just about comfort. Because when needle is like this, you need to keep 90 degree, and it's not comfortable to catch the skin. With a dot technique, I'm doing one pass dots and manual. It's like four or five passes, and it's done. It's not like full cover up of eyebrows. It's like dots technique, half of brow, just upper line in the beginning of eyebrow. Then it's manual shading, it's just in the bottom line and tail. So it's like one pass, combine two methods. And then making, so all we need is just create smooth gradient. It's like one more pass for get more dense color in the middle of eyebrow. The like couple passes for create smooth gradient, just somewhere, not like full brows. And you will see it in the video. So it's like four, five passes and it's done. Lots of my students ask me about diluting the pigments. I never dilute the pigment. Never. It's not reasonable. So it's better to control concentration by the technique. So if you need more transparent effect, just use more transparent technique. So when you work slow and a lot of strokes close to each other, color is more dense. If you need more transparent technique, you just start to work quicker and with space between strokes like this. So here is dense color. We are working right close each other and slow, and then go faster, 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 and super fast for get more transparent effect. I don't understand why people delete the pigment. It's like when you delete the pigment, you need more passes. Also, you can take bigger group needle because bigger group needle give you more transparent effect. No. I don't know, maybe I don't understand something, but I can't find any reason for myself for dilute the pigment. Антош, у нас не работает видео. It's not about this powdering technique. We don't need to like dilute pigment for diluting. We need to change the consistency. If your pigment is very thick, like rich of glycerin, we need to add some water for make it more liquid. So with your yes, in this case, yes, you are right. It's about length of the needle. So for soft powdering technique with a single needle, we need the bigger length of the needle and diluting pigment because needle works very, very quick and the pigment has to be liquid. So because this pigment can't go drop on the needle so fast like it work. So soft powdering techniques, it's about single needle and liquid pigment consistent. So if your pigment is very thick, rich of glycerin, you need to dilute it by water. But that's why нет, мне нужно упражнение на латексе. That's why I recommend to use tattoo inks with soft powder effect. На латексе упражнение домашнее. Он в самом конце, а он не загружается.
Which is close to green.
I forgot what I wanted to say. Diluting pigment. I wanted to show you the pictures. So this soft powder like this technique is very transparent and it's disappearing quick at time because dense colors stay longer. and tattoo inks is they are more stable, and that's why I recommend to use more stable pigments for soft powder effect for brows like this. And also we can I use soft powder with the liquid pigment, tattoo pigment, just with a skin like this, with the oily skin. If you don't want to use dots technique, you can use soft powder, but it's not so effective. But you can get this smooth gradient here. But for, I don't know, with soft powder effects, it's much easier to use tattoo inks because they are very high concentrated and you don't concentrate it, and you don't need to dilute them. I don't like to work with permanent makeup brands with soft powder effect. Oh, Chiara, I don't know. I didn't start to sell something yet. I'm like, people ask me all the time what to buy, and it will be much easier for me to start to sell something because everybody asks where to buy this, where to buy that, but I still did not doing it. Maybe it's good because I can be honest and I recommend what I use, and sometimes I change my mind because I still continue to teach, to learn something myself, and like sharing with my colleagues and something. And it's like if you need help with buy something, you can ask my assistant about it, but me, I don't know if you will start to sell something, and especially to create my pigment line. I don't, it takes a lot of time. Oh, for me, it's biggest pain because now people try to sell a lot of things, so it's about money, and they can't be honest because it takes a lot of years of experience. You need a lot of years of experience to create something, and it's impossible to work like 1 2 year and start to sell your own product line, machines, and some needles. How you can do it without experience? You don't know what you sell. And we are working these spaces with real people, and just masters believe buy machine, buy pigments, and continue to do it. And continue to do experiments on the faces of the real people. So I don't think that I'm ready to create my pigment line or sell something like my own machine. I don't know. For me, it's very, very big pain. So as a doctor, I understand what's going on, and I don't like it. So I don't want to be part of this business. So I recommend what I really like. It's absolutely, it's true. So what's going on in permanent makeup business now? It's not good. Not good. So with a like brand who started to who came into the market like 5 years ago, and they have already their own pigment, their own machine. It's like, how is possible if you start just 5 years ago? How you know? And about microblading pigments, it's very new now because industry is growing so fast. It's not so smart to use organic pigment because it's impossible to remove. So we will understand this mistake like 2 3 years later. And now it's boom of removal system because laser can't see like it's impossible to remove by laser organic pigments. And this is a big problem, and now it's like boom, let's learn removal system. And it's always about scars, and nobody knows what will be because they just create it and start to sell it immediately. It's like they have no like 10, 20 years of experience, and they are working with very aggressive solutions under the skin. And okay, we will see the result after like 4, 5 years. We will see what will be with our clients. Oh, thank you, Gemma. You remind me about aftercare. For tattooing, I prefer Mom or Fantasia or I always forget this. Mom is good. Now I'm using Mom or Fantasia. They have very tiny molecular and it looks really soft. Kiara, when we are working with tattoo inks, don't use dark brown because you see, even on this picture, this is very brownish at the beginner, and after healing, it's much colder. And after time, it's colder. So I recommend to use the brown color, not so dark like this. This client just begged me to do it. And but the tattoo, it's a little bit too dark. It's from the middle brown to blonde in a warm colors with tattoo ink, what is very important to know. But it's another term for conversation about tattoo inks or permanent makeup. I think we will make a one more webinar, and I will create a online course for about pigments because I see that lots of my students can't understand difference, and we need the basic knowledges about it for use it properly because now we have a lot of minerals brands, tattoo inks and organics lines in permanent makeup, and I really want to share my knowledges because it's very easy to do big mistakes. And now, Kiara, you can write me properly personally. I will give you mixes because I can't do it right now by webinar. So I have a special video in my online courses, and I will create new online courses with a homework with about soft powder brows, maybe in the end of February, and I will show the video, like proper video, how to mix pigment together, especially tattoo inks, and it will be in this course. Always welcome. Yeah, I think. Thank you, girl. Oh, you're so. This is a new format for me, webinars, and I was not sure that I can do it, especially with my level of the English. But I see that it works, and I see lots of people can be online straight at the same time. So I like the. The I like this way, and I can explain a lot of things because I don't need to write because usually I spend half of day like this on my phone, so for me it's easier, much easier to talk, and I can share by bigger amount of information. Yeah. Yeah, so I think I sure I will do it like every week. It's easier just 1 hour, and it's like a lot of information for you, for me. Okay, I think I can forget about aftercare. Thank you, Yara. Oh, you're so cute. I remind you that we will speak about aftercare a lot in my dots technique class. So please welcome. You can join, write me personally or write my assistant. And today about aftercare. What is my I always recommend one way of aftercare today. So you did a procedure and finish it. Put a tiny lay of Vaseline. Why? Just for clothes, open wood from the dirt. Yep, like not clean, not clean. Because your client will go out on the street and not clean air, and you just Vaseline is just for protection. So when your client go home on the road, I give cotton pads with the water or green soap with water. And by this cotton pad, they need to wipe their lymph or oozing lymph or itcher every 10-15 minutes. It takes like 2 hours. So they're going home on the road, they wipe it, their brows every 10-15 minutes to remove all lymph out the surface of eyebrows. After 1-2 hours, they need to wash their brows with the soap. Why? Because soap close holes from after puncture the needle, and you know that soap makes skin drier. And this method it helps to block oozing the itcher. And removes because you know that lymph is oily because it contains a lot of fat, natural body fat. And if you touch the lymph, it's like oil. And soap is clean this and it's black. What kind of soap? I recommend something very simple without some synthetic thing, but it's not very important. So I recommend antibacterial soap, or it's better to use antibacterial soap. So after this, usually brows getting dry. Like green soap or any type of antibacterial. Not all clients have green soap at home. So, but usually people have antibacterial soap. So after this, usually brows stop to oozing. But if it continues, so they need to continue to wipe it by cotton discs, and then after 1 hour, wash it with soap again. So this is the most important, the first day after procedure. Wipe it and wash with the soap. After this, skin getting dry, and before go to sleep, and this is the most important, before go to sleep, they have to be sure that it's completely dry. So by this way, cups will look like this. So then regeneration just looks like they lose some color. It's not like something extremely terrible, and skin is scalp is very thin, not thick. So it's about lymph. If they remove lymph today, immediately after procedure, the same day, they will not have thick scalp. So next day usually they need nothing, and on the third day they need like they start to feel like it's dry a little bit because scalp is dry, and they need Vaseline just for make Brows a little bit elastic again. It means twice a day, not often. In the morning and the evening, and it's more than enough. So when your client just feels that it's dry and it disturbs them, and if you move like this, it will crack. So they need the Vaseline just to prevent cracking, early cracking. So it's very, very thin layer, and not often than twice a day. That's it. And don't remove, don't touch, don't scratch, nothing what can disturb your yes, AD is okay, Vaseline is okay, everything. But I recommend them to use. I don't recommend to use oily. So AD is oil vitamin. It's better to use just pure Vaseline. Nothing too. It's not so important. It's just to keep them elastic, because. It's like I'm talking too much, really. I'm just like, why you need to put something healthy, like AD vitamins, aloe vera, or I don't know, something what can treat the skin if it's cap. It's already dead skin. Nothing can help. So scalp is a layer of dry itcher or dry lymph. Vitamins will not help. So you can put it after scalp fall, but on the scalp, on the dry scalp, nothing help. You only need to just put some. It's about consistency. So it's not about vitamins inside or something good, because there is nothing alive in this cup. So you don't. It's a bad idea to put something what can. I don't know how to, like, moisturizing the skin, because it's moisturizing the scalp and it's not good. So Vaseline is good, because Vaseline is like pure petroleum, and Vaseline makes skin drier, and so it looks like it's wet now, but in fact petroleum take water, like squeeze water out the skin. So if you use Vaseline regularly on your skin, for example, it's getting your skin getting drier. If you ever try lipstick, so when lipstick crack, you put this lipstick, like transparent lipstick, in the base of all transparent lipstick is a very similar like Vaseline structure, the petroleum thing, and you're just using it and 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 nothing help. Why? Because it's like you put it and it looks like your lips getting wet, but in fact petroleum take water out of your skin, so it doesn't work. It's better to stop. And if you want to something helps you to treat the crack. Thank you, Gemma. I hope it will help. And so if you need to treat your, if you need to use a cream with some regeneration, like I forgot this. Oh, it's like new brands for me in USA. Neosporin. Something like this. So it's not about petroleum lipstick. Don't use it, because it's like drug. You need it more and more and more and more and more. So little. It's the same with, but in the eyebrows, it's good because we need to keep them as dry as possible. Okay. What kind of different information? Just share and we can discuss because it's very important to think because they can tell something and that no there is no sense about it because they need just sell something to you and try to explain that they can treat the skin under the scalp. I don't know. I have a question. So if you want, we can discuss it. I have my opinion and I can explain how it works. So I'm always open. If I'm wrong, it's like, yes, I can be wrong, of course, because I'm a person. And I'm still learning and I'm still reading, and I'm very open. If you have any question, I can find some information and try to understand because it helps me as a teacher to improve my knowledges to share with you. So I'm still doing some experiments and continue to read a lot of information about everything. Thank you. So, any question, please welcome. Don't think that it's impossible to ask me about something. I'm very, very open to discussion. And if I'm wrong, I will tell like, oh, sorry, I was wrong. I was thought like this, but it's like this. So let's work by this way now. Okay. So, one more time about aftercare. Today, wipe it limp 10, every 10, 15 minutes. After 2 hours, wash your brows with soap. Be sure that your brows completely dry before go to sleep. And then Vaseline twice a day by very, very thin layer. That's it. And I was what do you think about hair strokes using the machine? Hair strokes is by machine, it's better than microblading. But with hair strokes of machine, you need to be technically very good. But with microblading too. And for hair strokes of machine, you need good equipment and good technique and good skin type, good pigment. So everything you need to understand every because it's like something goes wrong, just something a little like wrong pigment consistency and technique does not work. So for me, hair strokes it's about knowledge and skills. And hair strokes is deep technique even by machine. And hair strokes heal colder, so this you also need to know. So it's not like magic technique, but it looks nice sometimes. I like using combination of techniques, hair strokes with smooth gradient like ombre, because I don't like hair strokes here. For me, it's not reasonable also. So everybody's try it's like when people when masters trying to combine hair strokes in shading, they also start by hair strokes. And me, I prefer to do hair strokes on the arch area and tail because hair strokes is deep technique and the color looks more dense. And I don't like hair strokes in the beginning of eyebrow because by natural we have no line here, straight lines here. And when we do hair strokes, even if it's very thin, it's anyway it's lines. So it's two lines here, and it's too straight, and it always look unnatural because it's clear line. Like and when people look at this here, it's very visible. And brows doesn't look like they have smooth gradient here. So I like the beginning of like this. Smooth gradient, no clear lines here. And if sometimes clients ask, like, I want a hair strokes, I want a hair strokes, I want only hair strokes. Okay, if you want, I can do it. And I start to work in the here in the arch area on the tail and the in the middle of eyebrow, and I can go a little bit up, but on the up it can break because when brows look nice, they need a straight line here. Like, oh, I can draw. Nice. So, brows, it's straight lines, four straight lines, like this. And when hair strokes is here, it's break lines and the shape turn to circle a little bit. Sometimes I don't like it because archy brows a little bit more visible and it fix the shape and but sometimes just here a little bit it's okay. And here strokes on the bottom line, it's also my big pain because I don't understand why people trying to fix bottom line by hair stroke. Because hair strokes like this, we need to have a space between them, right? Right. So how it's possible to create line, clear, straight line, if we do, so how to have a line here if we need a line and we're trying to do to create line by strokes. There is no logic. So for create line we need a shading. So using so if all I can do is just make a S shape for hair strokes like this. But anyway, it's not like clear line which I need, so I always add shading on the bottom line because bottom line is the most important line for creator eyebrows because bottom line is the base of new shape. So this brows looks so good because they have an amazing bottom line and smooth gradient on the upper line and the beginning of eyebrow. Hair strokes can't do this effect so perfectly. Let's take a look. This is example of hair strokes. See, it's very thin, but it's anyway it look like a stroke. Like, and if you look a little bit from far, beginning of eyebrow does not look like smooth gradient. It's look like clear line on the beginning of eyebrow. This is example how microblading can heal on the not transparent skin. So it's a, you see that hair strokes is very thick. If you see the strong hair strokes, it's better to choose some dense techniques, which we was talking today about. And hair strokes is always if you need to, you see this here, we need the dark color for these brows. And if you take dark color for microblading, it anyway will heal cold, like grayish or bluish a little bit. There is no other option. It's impossible to get dark, warm color after healing and microblading. It's not because of technique, not about pigment. Not about your skills or somebody can do better. No, it's just because of depth of this technique. So all time microblading heals colder after healing, and it's a little bit grayish or bluish with a dark color. So if you see skin like white skin, not transparent, such a strong hair, brows. Don't choose microblading because with 90% it will not be successful. Yeah, one more time. This is I think it was microblading also. And here on this picture, I want to show that after healing, strokes is also. Oh, yeah. Glad to know it's not just me. Yeah, me too. I'm on your team. So my microblading with the dark color will heal cold too. And my microblading hair strokes will also spread after healing. And yeah. See, it was microblading, but it's spread because I think it was a little bit too deep. So after healing, it looks like shading, but just this shading not perfectly even because microblading is like. So it's obvious about space between hair strokes. Yeah, but yes, you can use dot stick. In a dot technique, you can use one single needle on the beginning of eyebrow on the upper line and three round with a dense technique in the middle of eyebrow or manual shading. What is the biggest plus to work with the dots technique, because it works with any type of equipment, comparing with soft powder effect and ombre techniques. You need a powerful equipment. With the dots technique, you can work by any type of equipment, if it's powerful or not powerful, tattoo or permanent makeup machine, doesn't matter, it will work. Dots is good because of it works for any type of skin. That's true. And I will. The one that was not fan of microphone menu. Yeah, that's true. And I was too. I understand something for myself that I'm not fan of some techniques, which is very popular, and I was politely silent. But now I decide it's like, okay, it's my online courses, it's my students, and why I want to tell truth. Maybe it will help. So I don't want you to feel that you are alone, and it's like everybody can do it successfully, post some beautiful pictures, and you think also, oh my God, what's wrong with me? Maybe I need to go and spend some money, like for new equipment, new needles, go to courses, spend a lot of money, and maybe I will be like them. But I'm trying to tell you truth that it's not like you need to understand that it's not all. All of teachers tell the truth because manual or machine for dot technique, both of them, because thank you. Yeah, it's business. It's business. Just I want you to understand that sometimes it's about your skills and equipment. Sometimes, yes, but not all the time. And some technique is not like so perfect like it look like. And we need to understand when it's work and when it does not. So this is my goal to teach. What do you recommend, manual or machine for dot technique? I recommend it's like both. both of them work, but this machine and then Scala, it's much difficult to work. So it depends on your skills, how good you are with the skills. And with some skin types, it's very difficult. So in this dots technique course, online course, I show more manual shading, because manual shading is always work with any type of skin, even if it's very sensitive or it's very thick. Manual shading will guarantee you healed result. And ombre with machine, it's not like everybody can do. It's I will create. Thank you, Gemma. I'm sure that you will like it. thank you. I will create a course, separate course for ombre technique, because it depends of skills, machines, and movements and pigments. It's a little bit different. But those techniques, it's like base. It's sometimes it's like you work and it does not. There is no result. You do one pass, two pass, three passes, wipe it, and it's nothing. Skin is bleeding, client is crying, and it's like, oh my, what I can do else? Okay, maybe she's in her period, maybe she's like have some blood diseases, maybe it's just very thin skin structure and a sort of blah blah blah, and maybe you can't catch right depth in the arch because it's the most difficult work for it's the most difficult area for work in the arch, in the bones border. Just take manual group needle and tuk 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 tuk, and that's it. So it is a secret and it will work. Thank you, Tiara. Yeah. So I did not work when I was start to work in my career. I started by single needle technique because it was the most popular like 10 years ago. And long time, like 2 years, I did not understand what's going on. My clients come back to me for touch up and it's nothing. I'm just look at them, it's like, oh my, it's too natural, like it was before. So I did one touch up, two touch ups, three touch ups, and I couldn't understand what I do wrong. And I'm working a lot with manual method now, last 3 years. So it's because it's easier for me and easier for my clients. I'm fix the shape and doing tap 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 and do dense color in the middle of eyebrows just by one pass. It means that I can finish my brows twice quicker than before. So it's very effective. I highly recommend to use it. Sometimes it's really help, especially with a difficult skin type like this girl. I remember this girl that I was working in Jamaica. And when I see her, I'm like, oh my, what I can do? What is the most effective way to implant pigment into the skin. And I did it, and when she came back to me in a couple of weeks, I was, oh my God, in the picture it's not so visible, but it was bluish, like light blue color, very beautiful. And I said her, like, relax, I know what I did. Because I know this method, everything will be okay. And she come back after 2 more weeks to me with this beautiful brows, and she is like on the picture with a flash. So her skin is very deep dark brown, and that's why I love manual method a lot. Because it's very useful to get a dense color. But also you need to know minuses, because it's very easy to do some mistakes by this method, and the manual method can look so even with a smooth gradient. That's why I combine that with another one with the dots technique. So please welcome to online courses. I still have a lot of things to say to teach. Gemma, write me personally or better to in dot technique about order it, and we will speak about needles because it's like one more conversation. I'm working with Soft Up. You can check their site, and I can guide you and share with my favorite needles. So this is my praise. Healed results never lie. So this is my rule to teach, my rule to work, and I hope that you like this webinar. And you can keep my number and write me WhatsApp personally for enroll the online courses. We will start dots technique after tomorrow. You can write me my Gmail, but it's better to use WhatsApp for me. And also you can find all information about courses and my site www.dixonpmu.com. The I will please welcome to the class. I'm talking about pigment a lot, but you need to understand the different technique, need a different type of pigment. So I will speak about pigments for dot techniques and in the dots class because it's a little bit specific because it's like microblading technique. It's a deep technique and heal colder. And for by this way, we need warmer color in the beginner. So in the cup, it has to be brown, warm color. And also, I use mineral pigments because I'm don't have a risk to take organic slimes because it's impossible to remove by a laser. And it's very stable, and organic slime also feel much colder. So it's a lot of think about talk. In the online course we will speak about if you ask about brand, I use Soft Tap. It's mineral, very high concentrated and very thick pigments. But for dot technique, consistency is very important too because with a manual we need thick consistency. So I love Soft Tap because they are thick, because they are high concentrated, and a light pigment is not good for dot technique, not perfect because for manual. But you can, if you will use machine method, you can use LI. Yeah. You can use a live velvet. Yeah. Oh, always welcome. So please welcome to Healed Result, Never Lie, Dot Technique course. This is a healed result from dot. This is immediately after. And also I want you to answer some questions. And it's for my statistics, so please share. Do you like your healed result for eyebrows? Yes or no? And your healed results are unexpected, often or hardly ever or always. I never know what to expect for. So be honest because it's It's about knowledge. So sometimes it's like I'm not like all the time have a perfect healed result, but I know what expect for. It's like, for example, if I see that clients came to me and it has very difficult skin for work, I explain my client. It's like, hi dear, you are very beautiful, but your skin is not good for my work. So with the high percent that we need to do touch up for you, and maybe color will not be so dense like we wish right now. So it's about experience, your experience, what to expect, and because it's much better to tell your clients before. It means that you understand what you do. So it's about your knowledges. That's why I ask this question, if you, how often you're surprised. It's like they came to you, it's like, wow, it's a lot. And next time it's like, oh, it's nothing. And you don't understand why. So I will give you lots of theory why it's important. And what needles for eyebrow you usually use? This question is very important for me because promotion is now about single needle and manual. Now, not a lot of training offer group needle courses. It's not so popular. And not a lot of masters use group needle in the work. And oh, yes, and this is my favorite question. What are you interested to learn online? It's about online. Okay. Oh, I really like this site. I see, I can see what is you are interested. Okay. Everybody wants to learn remover and lips and classic eyeliner. Yeah, if you see, yes, you can. Oh, let me read the question. If you don't have the same attitude, but I think it should be better. Yes, knowledge. Katrina, yes, knowledge about skin type will help a lot because it's the biggest issue to understand what will be, what kind of result you will get. Yeah, I see that everybody interested in the lips class and classic eyeliners. It means that you guys have problem with the retention for eyeliners and lips. Okay, yeah, very interesting. Eyebrow shaping, really? Wow, okay, if you surprised me, okay, I will try to create my courses as soon as possible. It takes a lot of time. Oh, Faith, really learn natural looking lips. Oh, Please welcome, because in my experience, I'm working only with natural lips. I don't like lipstick effect and permanent makeup because lips lose their shine. So natural lips course will be available in the February, and it will be about it will be about natural looking. I will tell a lot of bad things about bright color for the lips. Symmetry? Oh, okay. I'm not big of fan of symmetry of the face, but I love natural asymmetric. So, one second, Антон, я не понимаю, что такое шейпинг, куда им присоединяться. Please, I will analyze your answers. You surprise me a little bit. Okay, now I know what you are interested in. Yes, we will speak about shaping. I see that some students interested in eyebrows shaping. I will speak about shaping the dots course. So if you don't want to wait a lot, you can join now to. I'm surprised about what you want to learn. So I was thinking that microblading will be the most popular, but I'm happy to see that you are interested to learn lips and classic liners and eyebrows shading because it's very important. And not a lot of students asked me about it before. And I'm very happy that it's still interesting for you because it's the basic stuff. And I'm not happy that everybody wants to learn a remover because I'm not a fan of this method. And I understand why it's so popular now because we can use laser without medical degree. And it looks like remover will be nice to use, but with my experience, I've never ever I saw first removal by about 8 years ago, and since this time, I've never ever seen good healed result after remover. Yes, it's work, it can remove sometimes, but it's always about scar. You can see shining, glossing surface of the skin after remover, and it's felt that it's very aggressive and it's always chemical burn the skin, and it's saline or acid in the base of all removers, and it's like I just want you to know that there is no magic in this method, and it's very aggressive, and only by this way it's possible to remove something out the skin by chemical reaction. So I think I will create online course about it for tell that it's not so magical like you expect, maybe. I'm ready to create the course just to tell the truth about remover, and because when you know, you know what to do with it. Because yes, I sometimes use remover, but just a little bit, just little point here, little point here, and I'm trying to use it less as possible. But sometimes we have no other option, and by this way, yes, it's better to use remover than nothing. I've never tried hair removal, Belinda. I've never tried. But I think contain is the same. And I, for me, it's very expensive, and for me, it's not reasonable. Because for implant pigment into the skin very surface, you don't need such a, an expensive or an exclusive machine. There is some techniques to do it, but for I can say something, I can't say something bad or something good because I've never tried and never see it. There is no, when I was in Russia, it was not her product there. I'm a fan of laser remover. Yeah, so it, for me, it's more reasonable, and I understand how it works, and I saw a lot of good results by laser, and it's everything for master, and it's very difficult to work without laser, especially when you need to cover up some bad permanent previous tattoo. And I highly recommend to use a laser, and or if you can't do it legally, it's better to find somebody in your city with who you can work as a team, who specializes for this because it's good for your clients. It's not because sometimes you can't help. It's better to send it them for specialists and work with them together. It's better to be on side of your clients, think about them, not about your pocket. Yes, we are all in the business, and I understand, but like I want you to be like to have some knowledges, so then you can choose what is the best way for your practice, your reputation as a master, and your clients. Okay, thank you so much for your attention. I remind you that you can join my online course for this. You can write me personally or use my site. Please welcome everybody. Any question I can answer you in the next webinar, which will be in the next Monday at the same time. And or you can write me personally, or you can write me on online courses. So please welcome and have a nice day and have a nice evening. And I hope that you will have very good working week. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. I'm really enjoying it, spending time with you because you are very active. I love your questions. I love and I highly appreciate that you are ready to learn a lot and you forgive me for my terrible English because of my incredible charisma and taste of humor. I promise that I'm going to co take a courses and continue my education with English. I wish to see you guys, and but I feel that I like I have a lot of things to say, and I very hug person. I want to hug all of you. Thank you for being with me this Monday morning for me. I'm trying a lot and create my online course with from the bottom of my heart with like I wish to teach. I want to tell truth, to be honest with you, and it's full of love and full of my experience and that I want to share in. So please welcome, 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 welcome. And thank you so much. Okay. Mwah. See you next Monday. Thank you. Thank you, Faith. Thank you. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Oh. yes, and I remind you that we have a recording, so you can ask me to share with you by recording of this webinar. Okay. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Love you. See you in the courses.